decided to make my presentation on this book, The Fountain Head by Ayn Rand. Some of my friends who didn't read this story said, okay, fine, go ahead, it will be a good presentation. And some of my friends who had heard or read about this story said, it's not a good idea. It's a long book, it can have 645 pages. It's an elaborate story about different of characters, lots of characters. So it will be very difficult for you. It changed my mind a bit. So I thought, okay, maybe I should go for a simpler book. But then I thought, if I do that, I'll be compromising on my original idea. And that is what this book is all about. Never to compromise, never to sacrifice on what you believe in. Stand for what you are. You may have to face a lot of hardships, but stick to your principles. Always do what you feel is right. Even if it is wrong, stand by it. Because if it is wrong, one day you realize that I did a wrong thing. So, going ahead. About the author, it was written by Ayn Rand. She was a Russian-American novelist, born in Russia, then took American citizenship. Philosopher, playwriter and screenwriter. The book was adapted to a motion picture in 1949, in which Gary Cooper played the protagonist. And she also wrote the screenwriting for that film. She is known for two works that she had done. One is The Fountain Head and the second one is Atlas Shrugged. Her philosophy, her thinking, her ideas also developed a philosophy called objectivism. The storyline is, the story is about an architecture, Howard Rock, and the persons and the people he interacts with throughout the story, which mainly are his friend, a fellow architect, Peter Keating, architecture critic, Alfred M. Lucy, his lover, and our newspaper publisher. So these are the main characteristics. However, the story revolves around three people: Howard Roth, Peter Keating, and Elsa and Susie. These are the three people. Howard Roth is an architect, and Peter Keating is also a fellow architect. Elsa and Susie is an architectural critic. Now, about Howard Roth's character, is an individualistic. We say being individual is a bad thing to be, but he is. He doesn't mind what others think, doesn't care what others say about him. He just knows what he has to do. Believes that an idea should be pure and must be implemented whether wrong or right. Now this means that idea must be pure. It shouldn't be inherited by any other perception, any other one's perception. The thought which comes out of your mind should be pure, should be totally yours, and must be implemented whether wrong or right. Who knows, it might be wrong or it might be right, but until you apply that idea, you never know what the result will be or what the outcome will be next. Never compromise on your ideas. Always believe that I am doing the right thing. His existence matters most to him. For him, himself of being one was the most important thing in life. This can be more clearly stated by the statement it was in the book. He said, I inherit nothing. I stand at the end of no tradition. I may perhaps stand at the beginning of one. So this clearly indicates what kind of person Howard Roth was. Next character is Peter Keating, is an opportunist. Believes everything is ethical if it raises your position in the society. Do not mind using others to get what you wanted. Money and fame matter most to him. All in all, he was what we want to be or what we are supposed to be when we get into the role of a manager. True, it's hard to say these things, but it is true. We are supposed to be just like Peter Keating when we do a job or we go for some professional life. The statement was, it would be kindly to acknowledge people's existence by hating them. So he said, if you hate someone, you will have to urge to go ahead of them. You will have a urge to defeat them. But if you love someone, there is no urge like that. So it is better to hate them and move ahead of them rather than to love them. Next character is Alfred M. Suri, a diplomat, a man with vast knowledge, an extraordinary orator, allies with powerful people of the society. Makes people believe that what they do and say is always right, but could be better if they consider him. Power mattered most. He was a pure diplomat, just like the politicians we have in our today's world. He always made you believe that what you say or what you do is always right, but if you take my consideration, if you take my opinion, if you are 100% correct, you could be 200% right. So he made people believe that you are absolutely right, but you need me for getting better. His statement was, hands do perspire when held too long. I think you should all ponder over this statement. This is a very powerful statement. Now, life of our Prabhupada had to face a lot of hardships and criticism for all around the people, lived a long time with no money and very few friends, but finally changed the scenario of architecture in the modern world because he thought what he did was always right. He never succumbed to the situations that were poverty to him or the people that were criticizing him. Life of Peter Kelly always got what he wanted from life, money, status and power, but found himself all alone wondering about why, what he did and why he did that. And that why he did not choose his career in painting, which he was passionate about.
Akash, conclude.
Okay. Life of Ellsworth Sullivan enjoyed his position, adapted himself to every situation, throughout, managed to maintain his reputation. He knew that for his personal benefit, he had killed all his conscience and this bothered him. So these are the three different life patterns of three different people. They are some famous quotes from the Stoics. I am therefore, I think. Existence is identity, consciousness is identification. An inventor is a man who asks why of the universe and lets nothing stand between the answer and his mind. Contradictions do not exist. Whenever you think that you are facing a contradiction, check your premises. You will find that one of them is a wrong. Men of power want only one thing more power. Honest people are never touchy about the matter of being trusted. This also related to my friend Ajay's presentation that do not face problems being a lonely leader. So it is the same thing. Now the story raises a question, what is the most important thing in life? Is it money, is it fame, is it power, is it competence? It is on you to decide. Thank you.